this video, I'm going to teach you about using the sweep tool. The basics of sweep is that the profile which you create just follows a path. This is simple. This is the basics behind sweep tool. Now, going on into the tool, just open a path file which I have taught you in the previous tutorials. So now click on sketch. Click on the plane in which you need to sketch. So I am choosing here the front plane. Now you can use, now keep in mind that you are sketching the path which has to be swept. So always keep in mind that the path has to be an open path. The path cannot be a closed path. So you can use a line or a circle or a spline or an ellipse or an arc, anything, but it has to be an open path. So here I am just going to demonstrate you by creating a hook. So for that I am using the spline. So just clicking on it. It's a simple question mark. Now as you can see, this is a sketch which is going to be swept. I mean, this is a path on which the sketch is going to be swept. So now just click on the sketch again, or wait, just click on the sweep tool. Here you see a numerous commands. This one is sweep as a solid, just as you saw in revolve and extrude. The next one, which is nearer to it, is sweep as a surface. So this one is a create or edit sweep section, so that you can edit using this tool. So now I am going to create a sweep profile which has to be swept over the path. So if I click it, this is reorienting me to the path where the profile has to be sketched. So now I am sketching a circle of diameter 10 mm. So as you can see here, this is the profile which has to be swept over this path. So when I give tick, the profile is being swept. So this is simply sweep. And as you can see here, now this is completely solid. So if I choose sweep as a surface, see, it is swept as a surface. Now it is like a tubing. So we don't need that in this stage. I am going to sweep as a solid. And these two white dots here are used to extend your sweep path profiles. So if I just click and drag this, the profile extends, or I can even shrink it. So you can do it on this way. The same is applicable on this side too. You can either shrink it or you can either make it long. So I'll keep, you can either enter the manually value. So I keep it as a simple part. So the next one here which I'm going to teach you is these references. This just denotes it starts from the origin. The options from where the plane has to start. You can either choose this one or this one. Actually, these arrow mark which you can see here, the rose arrow mark, this one indicates Creo to start the profile. I mean, indicates a point from where the sketch has to be started. If I click it on the opposite direction, the sketch starts from here and it flows through here. If I click it in the opposite direction, the sketch starts from here and flows through here. So these are some tangencies. This is just property. If you give a tick mark, so now you can see the profile has been swept. So in this manner, actually, this is a simpler sweep. This is just a sweep tool, and I've just taught you in this video, in the small video, how to just use a sweep tool. In my next video, I'll teach you how to create an helical sweep and also how to sweep cut. So thank you, friends. Thank you for watching.